Good morning, K-5 friends. I'm Pastor Chongyun for 4th and 5th grade department. Today, we're going to read from Acts chapter 5, verses 1 through 6. If you have your Bible, please open to Acts chapter 5, verses 1 through 6. Now, a man named Ananias, together with his wife Sapphira, also sold a piece of property with his wife's full knowledge, and he kept back part of the money for himself, but brought the rest and put it at the apostles' feet. Then Peter said, Ananias, how is it that Satan has so filled your heart that you have lied to the Holy Spirit and have kept for yourself for some of the money you received for the land? Didn't it belong to you before it was sold? And after it was sold, wasn't the money at your disposal? What made you think of doing such a thing? You have not lied just to human beings, but to God. When Ananias heard this, he fell down and died. And great fear seized all who heard what had happened. Then some young men came forward, wrapped up his body, and carried him out and buried him. Amen. Boys and girls, what was your thoughts after reading today's passage? After I read this passage, I felt a bit scared. It was something that I've read in the Old Testament. You know, people are punished to death. But this is the New Testament after Jesus arose and ascended into heaven. So it definitely surprised me that Ananias and Sapphira died on the spot. What was the big deal of Ananias and Sapphira that caused death? And why God couldn't forgive them when Jesus died for all of our sins? And lastly, why is the seriousness of sin that we see in our lives? Ananias and Sapphira's together, they tried to do something against God. Why did Ananias and Sapphira bring the money to the apostles in the first place? Let's go to the end of chapter 4. Today we didn't read it, but we're going to go and check it out. It says, now the believers at the courtyard were of one heart and soul, and not one of them claimed that anything belonging to him was exclusive his own. So everyone had one heart to share what they have with others. They didn't think their money and property were theirs, but God's. Peter and John and the rest of the disciples never told people to sell their houses, lands, and properties. They did it voluntarily, and no one forced them or pushed anyone. Because the Holy Spirit inspired them, they became one heart and one soul to agree to do everything. And Ananias and Sapphira were part of it too. They went and sold a piece of property. Both Ananias and Sapphira had the full knowledge and complicity that they held back, which means they stole some of the money from selling the property. Then they only brought a small portion of it and put it at the apostles' feet. After that, we know the story of how Ananias and Sapphira ended with, which was death. Why do you guys think was the big problem that Ananias and Sapphira had? I want you guys to think about it. Did they face death simply because they lied? Absolutely, that was part of it. Lying was part of it. So if I end my sermon with, okay, boys and girls, don't lie, children, because there is a big consequence, is it really the heart of God for us and the thing that He really wants to teach us? Of course, lying was part of the issue, but it wasn't the big issue. It was only a surface problem. The real big problem comes from somewhere else. Let's read chapter 4, verse 32. It says, no one claimed that any of their possessions was their own, but they shared everything they had. The real big problem that Ananias and Sapphira had was that they believed their possessions were their own. And what's up with that? Well, Hebrews chapter 2, verse 10 says, everything belongs to God, and all things were created by His power. Even though Ananias and Sapphira claimed that they were Jesus' disciples, they didn't truly believe that. They believed the lies of Satan, that everything they had was their own, not God's. Therefore, as a result, they lied. Ananias and Sapphira properly talked to each other. Hey, what's the big problem that we keep a portion of our money? We are still giving a lot to the church, the disciples. We are not bad. Maybe that's how they thought. But God already knew their impure motivation. When Adam and Eve were in the garden, they believed the lies of Satan, not the truth of God. Remember that? They believed the lies of Satan. The lie was this. You need to be in control just like God. You need to be like God. On the other hand, the truth from God says, no, you are with God. Therefore, you have everything you need. The lies of Satan always tell us we need something. The truth of God always tells us that we have everything in Jesus. You see the difference here? In Ananias and Sapphira's situation, unlike other believers, they believed that the lie that God cannot provide everything for them. But the truth is, even if you sell all of your things, the land and property, that God is going to provide all the needs for you. Boys and girls, do you believe the lies of Satan or do you believe the truth from God? Do you always believe that I need something? Or do you believe that, no, I have everything because I have Jesus and I am in Jesus? Do you believe that even after you help out your friends, you help out the poor, you help out the needs, or even if you don't have anything, do you still feel okay because you have Jesus? Today, that's what we learned from Ananias and Sapphira's story. To be honest, I have no idea, and the Bible isn't that clear, why they have to die on the spot. We're not too sure. However, the truth that we know is both of them didn't have clean motivation. They lied to the Holy Spirit because they believed the lies of Satan. They believed that they need something instead of believing in God that they have everything in Jesus. So today I want to encourage you guys to tell yourself that I have everything because I have and I am in Jesus Christ. Let's all close our eyes and fold our hands and let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, today this passage was a little bit odd because we sort of seen this sort of situation in the Old Testament, but they weren't in the Old Testament era. Jesus already came and to forgive all of our sin, but today the thing that we have read in the passage was a little strange. And sometimes we don't fully understand why this has caused. But what we discover today is that a lot of the times we believe the lies of the enemy. The lies of the enemy that tells us that we need something, that we need everything when we have everything in Jesus. Lord Jesus, we pray for all these children, whether they have much or less, that they will truly believe that everything they have in their lives is really from the Lord. It's the blessings of God. Even if they don't have everything they want, that they will truly believe, we pray that they will truly believe that they have everything in Jesus Christ. Thank you for teaching us this story through Ananias and Sapphira. We pray that, yes, lying was part of the problem, but it wasn't everything. Help us not to lie just because we believe the lies of the enemy. Help us to have integrity. Help us to have honesty in our walk with Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for loving us so much. And we pray everything in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Let's pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you.
You opened up my eyes and gave my soul.